Good Monday evening, everybody, live and direct on Periscope and Twitter. I'm meteorologist Austen Onek, keeping you updated as to what's going to be coming our way as we go into tomorrow night. Nothing expected for tonight, but we could see again a few scattered showers as we go into very early tomorrow morning around parts of the Mid-South, and again, we may see the potential of some stormy weather as we get into and around the area toward about early Tuesday evening or so. That's going to be the main thing we're going to be looking at for right now. So if you have any plans for tomorrow, especially anything that involves picking up the kids from school, this is going to be something, again, that you definitely want to make certain that you are prepared for at this point in time. And again, keeping an eye on what's going on in the Mid-South area, especially if you live in North Mississippi, back into Eastern Arkansas and West Tennessee. So again, this is going to be a primary thing that we're going to be trying to do again for tomorrow, keeping you updated for the possibility of this storm system coming our way. And again, into tomorrow night could be a potential problem out there for the area. So again, this is what we're going to be looking for the rest of the day into tomorrow and into and around portions of tomorrow night. Monday night, I think things are going to be kind of boring. There's barely even any showers popping up even near us, but there could be some more problems as we go into and around close to tomorrow night. So that's what we're going to be looking for this time. Not trying to hype the weather, just trying to make certain everybody is updated as what needs to be going on for the forecast as we head through the rest of the day tomorrow. So please keep yourselves safe if you live in and around the Mid-South area, and we'll keep you updated on News Channel 3. Big Earl 88, welcome to the show. Thanks for joining us on Periscope and Twitter. Coming up, we'll do a quick check of the forecast, and we'll take a look at what's going on with radar, which again, doesn't amount to much for right now. But as we go into tomorrow night, we'll give you an idea as to what we're looking at and when coming up in just a little bit. Currently in the Mid-South, we have little, if anything, really to talk about at this point in time. Things are very quiet. Looking directly around the area for Memphis and Shelby County, there's really just not much of anything going on. Looks like the radar may be, okay, radar is updating. Sorry about that. Thought we had a bit of a lag taking place. Now back to the west, we do have a few more scattered showers taking place around central Arkansas, back into around Mountain Home, north of Little Rock, and looks like a little bit of a shower taking place right around Augusta and down toward, or looks like Beebe, Ward, Cabot, and close to I-40 for this evening, but the heaviest activity right back close to Greer's Ferry Lake and well to the west of the Jonesboro area, but really not much more than that at this point. But it's not tonight that we're going to be worried about for right, or at least concerned about, I guess I should say, for right now. Let's go ahead and give you a quick check of the forecast for the time being. R.P. Fink, welcome to the show on Periscope. Thanks for stopping on by for tonight. Looking again for much of the area tonight, low temperatures, not all that low in Memphis. North of Memphis into and around northeast Arkansas, that's where we see some pretty cool numbers tonight, back into around the lower 50s or so for much of the area. So we're getting some fairly cool numbers across much of the area through tonight. And then south of I-40, that's where, again, that stationary front is stuck across the area, and that's doing a very good job of keeping the warm air down to the south and the cold air back to the north. So we just don't have that much in the way of very cool air starting off into the evening hours. Now tomorrow, much warmer. Highs back in the mid to upper 70s and even close to 80 degrees around Tupelo. So warm and also very windy. Winds tomorrow will be out of the southwest at about 20 miles per hour plus. That's regular sustained winds. Wind gusts will be possibly pushing 30 miles per hour into tomorrow afternoon. And that is why the National Weather Service has issued a wind advisory until 7 o'clock tomorrow evening. Both of these will start at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning, 7 o'clock in the evening for the expiration date here as that front passes across the Mississippi River, and then until 10 o'clock for areas east of the Mississippi, West Tennessee and Northern Mississippi, and Shelby County again right there in the middle area where we see the rest of that going on. We've got a stationary front stuck across the area for tonight, but that is going to be making its way back to the north as a warm front, and as it does, we'll be looking for that warm front to run into a large storm system coming in from out west, and that's going to be moving into the Mid-South as we get into around afternoon and evening, pretty close to dinner time tomorrow night. So we could be looking at some much more our problems with our forecast coming up tomorrow evening. Add to that, again, some windy conditions, and again, the possibility of some much colder weather coming on through. Upper 30s, lower 40s as we go into Wednesday morning. Highs on Wednesday will be much cooler, some 20 degrees cooler as we get into around Wednesday afternoon. Winds may be a little breezy at first, but they should calm down a little bit out of the northwest. That's going to help to escort in some of that dry, cool, and stable weather. But here's part of the problem we're running into Wednesday night. Could be some widespread frost across the area. I know by email and by phone calls, a lot of you in the Mid-South area have been very busy keeping an eye on the garden, getting plants ready to go, stuff like that. And if that's the case, you're going to have to cover them back up again or move them back in if you can, because we could see some widespread frost across parts of the area as we go into Wednesday night, Thursday morning. And at the bus stop, these are the numbers that the kids are going to have to deal with, so please keep that in mind. By Thursday, high temperatures bounce a little bit as the winds turn back out of the south, and we see some much nicer numbers back into the mid-60s or so. All right, that'll take care of just a little glimpse of the forecast. We're really trying to focus in on the potential, again, for severe weather. From wxcharts.eu, a very neat place to go to for some animated maps out there. You're looking in the upper left-hand corner of this map, again, going through the area close to around from dinner time tonight and through about midnight tonight, the blue and the green showing the potential for just some plain rainfall. I would not be surprised to see a thunderstorm or two out there, but really not much more than that. And then we get into around tomorrow afternoon. Now, could be a few thunderstorms popping up early as we go into around just about 9 to 10 o'clock in the morning. Around lunchtime, we could be looking at the potential of a few showers, but not that much happening just yet. And then right about dismissal time for the kids, and about the time we get ready for rush hour home, large line of thunderstorms develops back to the west of us. Southeast Missouri, central northeast Arkansas, northeast Texas, northwest Louisiana, and that's what's going to move our direction as we go into around rush hour finishing up and right around dinner time and afterwards. So tomorrow evening, outdoor activities, whatever's going on outdoors, this is what you're going to have to deal with. And inside that line could be some embedded supercells. It's not a great possibility, but with this much moisture and this much, again, energy coming through the area, I would be looking for that, and we can't rule out the possibility of isolated tornadoes. Now, several hours ago, the Storm Prediction Center raised the threat for the potential of severe weather to an enhanced, the orange polygon that you see there covering over all of West Tennessee, Northwest Mississippi, and a good portion of Northeast Arkansas, including the Missouri Boot Heel. Now, this forecast is unfortunately several hours old. We're expecting a new one for day one starting for tomorrow, somewhere around just after midnight, and then we'll get a better idea as to what we'll be looking for. But this forecast is a lot more intense and a lot more active than what we saw from yesterday's forecast. So it looks like the threat for severe weather has increased quite a lot. Now, could this decrease? Yeah, absolutely. Could it change into complete and total absolute nothing? Yeah, absolutely. But as of right now, we have to take this into account and make certain that we are watching the potential to see what may be going on out there when it comes to anything involving severe weather. So an increase in severe weather, what we're looking at here, that's something that we really have to be paying attention to into tomorrow. Now, what exactly are we looking for? According to the Storm Prediction Center, mainly the possibility of damaging winds and large hail. But there is always going to be, and I know some of you don't like to hear this, but you have to know about it, there is that potential of maybe some severe weather involving tornadoes. It's never fun to tell people about that, but as a professional meteorologist who does not hype the weather, regardless of what other TV stations in this town say, we present the weather and make certain that you are safe by knowing ahead of time what might happen. So there it is, watching the potential of this, something we're going to have to pay attention to into tomorrow. Storm Prediction Center and the National Weather Service in Memphis calling this again significant, to where we could see again the possibility of severe weather into tomorrow. And again, damaging winds, hail, the secondary threat, and again, isolated tornadoes, something we're going to have to pay attention to. Also, that potential for the possibility of freezing temperatures in the Mid-South as we get into and around Wednesday night, Thursday morning. So once again, if you have plants outdoors, you're going to need to protect that. But the main thing out of this is that potential for severe weather. Anything past about, I would say, lunchtime Tuesday through dinner time west of the river, and then dinner time and afterwards going across the Mississippi River, heading back to the east toward the Tennessee River in West Tennessee and northern Mississippi. That's going to be the worst of the worst from what we're looking at for right now. So again, that's the time frame for what we can see at this point in time. We have nothing in the way of anything involving severe weather watches. Leah Smith Allen, thanks for joining us on Periscope for tonight. Glad to have everybody stopping by. And again, we'll be paying attention to this pretty closely into tomorrow. Don't forget about that wind advisory. Well, looks like that disappeared off my screen. There we go. Wind advisories in effect starting at 10 o'clock tomorrow. So please pay attention to more there. Stop by my Facebook page for more details, facebook.com/AustenOnek, WREG. And also keep attuned to my Twitter page as well. We'll keep you updated on that. The National Weather Service asking us in the media to pass this along. There was supposed to be a Skywarn training session tomorrow evening at the Emergency Operations Center for Tipton County. That's just one county north of Shelby, Brighton, Tennessee, 8629 Highway 51 South. Because of the severe weather threat tomorrow, the National Weather Service would rather have all their personnel on duty at the National Weather Service just in case this turns into a more dangerous situation. So this meeting has been postponed. It has already been rescheduled. It'll be 1 week from tomorrow, not tomorrow on April the 3rd, but on Tuesday, April the 10th. Same location, different date, same time. So if you'd like to know more about Skywarn and how to become a spotter, this is where you want to go to. It'll be the EOC on Highway 51 South in Brighton, Tennessee. Great opportunity to learn more about severe weather, so please consider becoming a spotter. One more course after this, it'll be in Helena, West Helena, Arkansas, in just about 2 weeks. So if you'd like to take the course, stay tuned for more on my Twitter page, and we'll keep you updated, again, on everything that is going to be going on there. But the main threat, again, for severe weather is not going to be for tonight. Catch my forecast bright and early tomorrow morning with Bob and Josh starting at 8 o'clock, and that's on AM 730, or if you can't dial them up, again, on the radio because you're too far out of town, all you have to do is go to talkbacklivenetwork.org, and you can find out a lot more about sports chat in the Mid-South. Great show to listen to, so make certain you tune in and check out my News Channel 3 forecast there available as well. That'll do it for this edition of News Channel 3's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime for Periscope and Twitter. So far, again, things are quiet for now, but by this time tomorrow night, may not be looking that way. We'll have more details throughout the rest of Tuesday. Keep it tuned to this website, wreg.com/weather. Got any questions? Email me. It's in the blue bar a little farther upwards there at austin.onek@wreg.com. Keep it tuned. News Channel 3's Jim Jaggers has your forecast update on News Channel 3 at 10 in about an hour and 10 minutes, so stay tuned for that. And Todd Demers has more coming up on News Channel 3 Daybreak. Thanks for joining us tonight, and keep it tuned to News Channel 3 all day long tomorrow for updates on severe weather.